Well, this past weekend, our fellow anchor, Howard Dashefsky, hosted a reunion at his house for his two-year-old lab, Jameson.
It was adorable, and it got him and many others asking, do dogs remember their siblings years after being separated as puppies? Well, Howard joins us now with our local pet expert to discuss more. Hey, Dash.
Hey, ladies. Thank you very much. I'm with Candace Denham, and we're coming here from Labrador Park. Look, what a beautiful day, right? It's actually quite lovely. Look around. Can you smell the grass? Anyway, yeah, we had this great reunion. Before we get into the conversation with Candace, if you didn't see it on our website, I want to show you the video. My son, Jameson, with his two sisters, Sachi and Bumpers, they got together. This is the first time they've been reunited since they were separated at 12 weeks. And they were separated at 12 weeks, 2 years and 3 months ago, and they got together, and immediately you could tell there was a connection. Well, it could be just because they're crazy Labradors, and they're playful, and they're loving, and they're just wonderful dogs. I'm going to stand close to you, Candace, because my mic, I guess, is cutting in and out a little bit. But the reunion went wonderful. We posted on the website with a question, do dogs remember their siblings? Look at how well behaved they are. Okay, well, we are joined by, look at the three of them. This is Sachi, and this is Bumpers, and Sid. They're both well behaved. And I want to bring in Candace because answer that question. I pose it to you. Do dogs, siblings, remember themselves 3 years after two? Years and 3 months in this case after being separated.
Right. Well, there's not a lot of studies to support, canine emotional health and things like that. But they're starting to study that a little bit more because people are interested in knowing what their dogs are thinking. And the thing that they find is that if dogs are together for about 4 months with their siblings, then they're better likely to recognize their scent. And that's what it is. It's not necessarily a conscious awareness that they're siblings, but more just the scent that they recognize.
Okay. So I was doing a little reading and research, and dogs, labs are incredible sniffers,
right.
But some dogs have 10,000 times to upwards of 100,000 times better sense of smell than we do. So that's really where that imprint comes in.
Right. So all mammals' brains are pretty similar when it comes to shape and things like that. The sizes are obviously different, but the scent area in the dogs is much more utilized than other mammals.
You could see the three of them, again, just completely took to each other. Let's talk a little bit about the broader sense of dog intelligence, because we know if there's, say, a death in the family, a human death, or you have two animals or more and one of the animals sadly departs us, the dogs, like the humans, undoubtedly go through a sense of mourning.
Right. There's definitely a grieving phase between housemates or between an owner and a dog. There are studies now where dogs have been trained to sit for an MRI, and they're presented with emotional stimuli, and parts of the brain light up, just similar to humans. And so we're finding out more that the dogs are experiencing more complex emotions. As far as cognitive ability, it's still hard to say because they obviously can't communicate that to us. But there's definitely times where it's obvious that the environment has changed, the behavior changes when they lose a housemate, an owner, things like that.
Yeah, certainly I know when I pack my little rollaway bag to leave town for whether it's a couple days or a week, not so much Jameson, who I couldn't bring in today because two is enough. He would have had to have been here 8 hours. But when I leave, there's no question that he, and more so my other dog, Guinness, they get really sad. They know I'm going away when they see that suitcase.
Right. Dogs are very observant of their environment, and that's how they perceive their world and communicate, is they're looking for body language, they're looking for tone in the voice. So some can have vocabulary that they recognize, but it's probably more about the sound and not necessarily the symbol of the word.
Yeah.
Right? So it's how you say it and what they are familiar with.
Okay, I want to say for the record, these dogs will never be service dogs, but they are so loving and playful and wonderful to be around. Just going back to that original question, again, we have no definitive answer, but can we believe that they know each other?
I mean,
it's more fun
absolutely.
To think that. But you
absolutely.
Really, but
let's just believe that.
but you really do think there's something behind it, that there's a recognition.
There's definitely a lot of anecdotal things that I've encountered as a vet over the years, experiences that people have shared with me about their dog's response to different things. I had one client who said that her her dog that had passed away, they went to spread the ashes in the ocean, and her dog that normally doesn't like water jumped in and didn't want to get out. So something like that is clear evidence that there's something going on there. We don't know exactly what they're understanding, but it's clear that there's something happening.
All right. Dr. Candace Denham of the Kailua Animal Clinic, Saatchi bumpers, and to our human friends for bringing them, thank you very much. And next month, a great issue. We're going to talk about dogs and humans. Can they transmit flu, colds, ratworm, lungworm, back and forth to one another? That's going to be interesting. That's right. It's our cue to wrap up.
Communicate.
Thank you for the cue. Bridget, Lauren, we send it back to you guys.